What's going on? Everybody, remember we're starting a little bit early today. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. This is an alert service. I'm not going to make you direct trade recommendations. What I will do is conduct some live fundamental and technical analysis. With some luck, we can put together a profitable trade plan or two. Please bear in mind that massively leveraged is risky, particularly when you leverage 50 to 1 and sometimes more. On the odd occasion, this leverage will work for you, unfortunately, more times than not. As a novice, it'll also work against you, so please do not trade that hard-earned money until you have a track record of success using a broker's PlayPlay account. Past performance does not predict. Past performance does not predict future success, and I hope that you enjoy the session thoroughly. So, what's news? What's cutting knives and blades? I see a couple of interesting opportunities there. I think we'll probably be largely counter-trend. But I actually see a few decent opportunities presenting themselves here hypothetically. So let's take a look at, we can start with the pound. I actually had us going long, Albert. I think we'll probably be short here initially, followed by longs. We're coming off our central pivot on the euro-dollar. You had weekly reversal pivots for the pound and the Australian dollar. Let's clean this up a little bit, and we'll get stuck in. Should we start with the euro? Now, the euro is, we're at our daily 5 on the euro-pound. So, I'm wondering if the pound dollar isn't going to be the better bet. Although it's at resistance. 6 of 1, you know, we can start with, we can start with this euro, shall we? Start at the beginning. As I say that, I switch to the pound dollar. There's a couple of key things today that I've been noticing. Hi, Susan. All right. You guys all remember we're starting a little bit early today? Morning, Hector. Let's clean up this... clean up the situation a little bit. All right. One thing I did want to mention, and we've sort of had this on our radar for a long time, is this Dow Jones chart. This is a daily coming off this resistance level at 1300. It's 250 points down from the top that we called at 1304. 13,045. And what I'm expecting here is that we pick up this 21 and actually jog down about another 300 points. Okay? And then we'll continue up. We drew this line, when was it? Back in beginning of February. Actually, middle of January, to be honest, because that's when we started our little thing. So this has been 2 months in the making, and so far so good with that. And you can actually see this is manifesting itself in things like the Australian dollar, things like the euro, things like the pound. So if we're going to pick up this 21 here and push to the downside, it stands to reason that we could probably do something similar in our currency charts. You know what I mean, Doug? And New Zealand is killing the South Africans in the Test cricket. Bit of a massacre at the moment, if I'm honest. A little bit of a massacre. A Test cricket. Dang. What? Always used to wear it on my sleeve a little bit if my team didn't do too well when I was in South Africa. I used to have a log. Now that I don't have any national pride, I honestly just watch cricket to watch cricket. So, anything here on this 2 hour chart specifically that has got your attention today? I'll give you a minute to think about that. That's what I saw too, Christine. I saw these stochastics. The 5-8 cross is trying to cross up. You're absolutely right. The 4 hour is crossed to the upside and trying to penetrate the trade zone. But this is pretty compelling. And we know that our 2 hour stochastics, they're pretty good at the direction game. You know, so when I look at something like this, I see sort of, I'm anticipating something like that. Not to mention the fact, that we are at our weekly reversal pivot points. All right, let me show you a daily chart here for a minute. Doug. Save current layout, yes. Now, this is the DealBook 360 trading platform with indicators. I mean, excuse me, with the 5-8, with the 5 EMA and nothing else. But what I wanted to point out is two things. One of them was the 2 hour stochastics. Two is this 5 EMA, which is quite a distance from price, all of 50 pips. Three is, and three would actually be more than two, and I lied to you and I said I have two things to tell you, but notice how this is also these candle wick bodies here, wicks, wick body. This is where these candle wicks stopped out. Okay? You know, notice there, the hesitation there going back to March. And here we are, February rather, here we are again. So, I think, you know, ultimately I see us coming down here to this 56.50, but I think we're going to go back to around 57.80 to 58 and then finish the job. What do you think of that? So, in other words, a green candle here. You think it's reasonable for us to see a green candle? Or do you just think we're going to continue to bust a move, so to speak, to the downside? Right. Got a little inverse sort of crown head and shoulder pattern going on in the Australian dollar right now, which is the same play of the weekly reversal pivots. Anyway, I don't think that this is the start of an uptrend by any means, but I do think that you know, this is also the 3-2, so we have a lot of support here. We do. We have a lot of things and stuff. So let's go back to our conventional chart. Our central pivot is at 57.60. I don't think we're looking for a massive trade here. What do you think? You're at your 4 hour 5. So, you know, I would like to see a little higher low before it did that, preferably. It's tough for me to long right where it is. However, would we, you know, the question I have for you is, would we consider the bounce actually happening on the previous candle, if I show you the Audi? You know, would we consider the 4 hour 5 already respected on that swing? If it is, you know, then we've got permission to, you know, sort of look at it basically where it is, but it seems like it's tough spot to buy it precisely where it is. Did you guys long this stuff in Asia? Now look at something like this on the euro, and obviously this is just me being Captain Hindsight, but I think it's pretty evident looking at the daily chart that things are going to get long today, and then you get your 15-minute change of trend, and right at the Asia open you get a pullback to the 50%. Did any of you long this? Rob walk you through that. He has your 15-minute change of trend. 2-hour stochastics pointing to the upside, 15-minute. Okay. Asia's a good session, guys. I'm serious. Asia's very tradable.
City eyes.
Good job, Larry. Is that not the stuff that we teach you a lot of, though? I mean, daily support, change of trend, 50% fib, double bottom at that 50% fib, Asia open. Good move. 25 pip trade, but it's going to go further. You tried to short the 4-hour 5, Albert. I think if Asia started, to me, this would be a red zone here. So if Asia started sort of there, I would have shorted. Yeah, I don't think that was crazy. I mean, you're bouncing off 31. I don't think that was. I could see how you could have jumped on that. I see. 31:43. Okay, well that's a. Well that's okay. That's different. I thought you were trying to get short sort of here, but I can just see how this is a little change of trend of 31, and you also, yeah, all good, Eric. Thanks. We need to have a look at the Aussie too, because the Aussie is basically 105.20. We know is good support. It's also reversal pivots, and you're getting all sorts of 15-minute opportunities here. So I don't want to ignore this because this is trying to do something like this. This is a rule 9 here, and that's 50 pips. So, anyway, let's finalize this pound trade plan. Star-spangled banner. Get wave. I see the Aussie turning into a rule 9 situation. Yeah. So where would we be comfortable taking it long in this pound, do you think? Trying to. Something in here, maybe, in this range area. Two-hour stochastics. So something, you see this range here? It's a little energy level for price. So if we could get this down to 57.20 or so. I think it's worth a shot underneath 57 stop with a target of 57.80 in mind. Okay. Oh, the finish, bam, lamb. Oh, the finish, bam, lamb. That's a 382/50 percentile of today's move. Don't really want a long run here into the 4R5 hourly 21 EMA. So it's going to have to come down for us. It's going to have to give us something a bit better there. Also, maybe it's time to look at the yens today. That pound yen. Remember, I was drawing up some stuff from the beast. I think this is our level we expected it to go long. Yep. This is resistance here because of this 127.20, but maybe we can start looking at longs on that on a higher low or something and trading it back to 128. Also, the dollar index is coming off 79.85, which was a very good area of support and resistance going back a while on the DX. You guys notice that? Did you all notice that? I don't think everybody got the memo. We're starting early. We're going to have some disgruntled customers. All right, any questions, concerns, or otherwise on this pound? Between 20 and 10, I think, is where I'm going to bang it. And then, you know, I'm going to start looking between sort of 50. This, to me, is red zone 3 here. I know it's a large-ish range, but I think that's roughly we want to try and continue the short. Yeah, I mean, if we can get this entry, Shane, in the next sort of hour or next 45 minutes, that's perfect. You know, and if it's there at London Open, then yeah, perfect. You know, basically I'm expecting that. Okay. I'll do this trade with you. Any questions about the pound? How are we looking news-wise today, troops? Foreign currency reserves and another dumb prediction in the morning. German factory orders, nobody cares. All right. Well, you know, here's some pivots for you. One, remember the first chart we looked at was the Dow, and we said, well, we're probably going to come back to that 21. So green there is the implication tomorrow. You know, here on these pivots, you got your 4 hour trying to turn to the upside, and you're in the reversal pivot zone. You have 105 and weak reversal pivots, and you've come down to the reversal pivot zone on the weekly here as well. You know, Euro, I would see us like to come off that central first. You know, it could have gone down here initially. I doubt it without going up first, you know. But certainly the Aussie and the pound are coming off reversal pivot points. The other thing to think about, it's funny, yesterday Omnovia destroyed my computer. Today, everything's running happy as a clam. Technology, it baffles me at the best of times. Technology. Right, this, look at this zone on the dollar index. High, high, low, 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 high. Hello. Important level, isn't it? Important level. So, you know, a little retracement off there, at least to the daily 5, to be expected. It's operator error, Eric. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Is that pound going to pick us up? 4 out of 5, do your job. Do your job. Yeah, I do, but this is pretty counter trend with respect to the 4 hours, so we'll see. I do remember yesterday all too well. But, you know, I'm then, I could have, you know, it goes against my core religion and beliefs to long there. But yes, I do remember it. Yeah, I'm going to go back to the Aussie in just a sec and I'll show you what I mean. You got a higher high out of that now too. Okay, no questions on the pound. We're down to hope now. I love the 2 hour on this. Love it. Heavy. Okay, if there are no questions on that, let's say goodbye to the folks joining us in the free environment.